Happy Monday Fun Day to you. This is my day off, so I'm about to go out and play in my yard, but I'd like to share a little devotion with you first. And we're going to read from the second creation account. There are actually two creation stories in the Bible. Genesis 1:1 to 2:3 and Genesis 2:4 and following. So we're going to read Genesis 2:4, and they're quite different. In the day that the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, when no plant of the field was yet in the earth, and no herb of the field had yet sprung up, for the Lord God had not caused it to rain upon the earth, and there was no one to till the ground, but a stream would rise from the earth and water the whole face of the ground. Then the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being. And the Lord God planted a garden in Eden in the east, and there he put the man whom he had formed. Out of the ground the Lord God made to grow every tree that is pleasant to the sight and good for food. The tree of life also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. A river flows out of Eden to water the garden, and from there it divides and becomes four branches. The name of the first is Pishon. It is one that flows around the whole land of Havilah, where there is gold. And the gold of that land is good. Bedlam and Ont stone are there. The name of the second river is Gihon. It is the one that flows around the whole land of Cush. The name of the third river is Tigris, which flows east of Assyria. And the fourth river is the Euphrates. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to till and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You may freely eat of every tree of the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. For in the day that you eat of it, you shall die." And the Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. Man gave names to all cattle and to all the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up the place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God made had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. The man said, "This is at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken." Now, through the magic of video, we're going to transport out into my backyard. So here we are out in creation. I happen to be out with my three dogs, and creation was given for us to enjoy, to grow food and to grow that which the animals need and to create beauty. I think that's why I like the garden so much, because I realized that creation, God's creation, is about relationship. Our relationship with the ground, our relationship with the animals, and ultimately our relationship with other people. You know, God kept trying to find a helpmate for man in this story, and tried all the different animals, and none of them seemed to quite do it until God put man asleep and performed the first surgery and took a rib out, and there was woman. And I think about that story, that all those animals were made for relationship. You know, not just the ones we like, the dogs and the cats, but all animals were made for our relationship with each other. Whether that was
a way to receive nutrients or food, or whether that was for companionship, or whether that was just for sheer beauty. Like, I enjoy watching the birds as they feed off the bird feeders that I set up. Just like the plants. Some are created for food and nourishment. Some are here for just the sheer beauty to look at and to enjoy. And I think that's what we're called on to do with creation. Often many of us think it's ours to destroy, but it's not. It's ours to be stewards of, to care for. Because this is not our land. I mean, I might have my name on a title and a deed that says this land is mine, but in reality, it's not mine. I'm only renting it for a few years. We're all only renting our space here on Earth for a few years, and then it gets handed down to the next group of people in relationship with God. See, God doesn't call on us to destroy His world, but to tend it, to care for it, to be stewards of it. I remember when I was a child, I took out my dad's compass. I was given a chance to use my dad's compass as a young Boy Scout, and as long as I used it for proper reasons, well, I used it to play armies with my friends, and I died dramatically once and threw the compass up in the air, and as I watched it shatter upon the ground, I tried to argue that, well, you gave it to me to use, so I used it, and it broke while I was using it. But that wasn't really a good excuse. My father gave it to me to use properly, to use as it was intended, not to use as a prop in my game of army. And most of all, he gave it to me to use to care for, and I destroyed it. Kind of view that's how God looks at us in creation. God calls on us to use creation for the beauty of it, to care for it, to make sure that others get to use it in the future. That this creation is for us to care for and to love and to be in relationship with the people, the animals, the plants, all the things of this earth. And when we start hoarding it and acting like it's mine, we ignore who the real owner of creation is, God the Father. So I think that's why I like the garden so much, because it reminds me that this isn't mine. This is God. This all belongs to God. The gardens I make, the animals I keep, even my wife and my children belong to God. So I'm supposed to care for all of those things as if they are God's things, showing them love and grace and being in relationship with them. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for giving us creation, for giving us those things in the world that we enjoy, those people in the world that we enjoy. Help us to care for them as you call us, to be good stewards. Help us to see that we are in relationship with all of your creation as a gift for us to care for and to nurture and to tend. Be with us in our tending. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have a great Monday. I'm going to go out and play now.